Sorry, y'all. Gotta get the receipts because y'all got me fucked up. Y'all got me really lit. No, she had the orange wig on. The orange one. That was the first one, baby. It was multiple ones. Here we go. Well, no, she didn't have the orange wig on. I'm sorry. She had my clothes on. Yeah. It's a lot. I try to remember. So this is the first one. So I'm in Orlando. This video was posted on December 2nd. Now, this is not while I was in Orlando for my birthday. When I was in Orlando for my birthday, I saw one of my tops that I left out being worn by her, and I confronted her about it, and she told me she got it from Forever 21.
No, she did. She went in your room, digged it up, and had it on. She
yeah, she dug through room. My stuff. Yeah. Okay, let me find it. Diamond. I said, hey, so we do my stole my clothes. Let's see. Okay, boom. Okay, here's this first receipt. I said, I sent one of the bills or something on my bank account showing money I didn't receive. And I said, and are you wearing my top in your story? She said, what the fuck to me not getting her money? And then she said, LOL, no, I went to Forever 21. I said, no, the camo top, because she had on a white windbreaker that you do get from Forever 21, because I have the black version. I said, oh, LOL, sis, then we matching. But in the back of my mind, I'm like, okay, I can't say nothing because I'm not there, so go ahead and lie. I said, the camo, right? She said, it's a crop top. What kind you have? I said, yes, you copped that at Forever 21. She said, yeah. So at that point, I knew she was lying. I said, I have a matching set of that with the top and bottom. We could have been head-ass LMAO, meaning matching. But I knew we couldn't match because I knew it was mine. And then she was like, but anyways, yeah, PayPal or the bank be tripping. Okay, so that was that. So, wore my clothes while I do. I had my door open. No key was in my door yet because I was getting my wooden floors done. I feel our talk was pointless because we had to talk about respecting each other's belongings. I said, she said, I'm out. I can't. That's why I'm having her do it. Okay, because she was supposed to send me her half for Wi-Fi or something. And she said that she was out. Mind you, y'all, she accidentally FaceTime called me and I answered and she was in the house. I said, I want us to have that understanding and respect for each other. And I seen you was just in the house and you FaceTimed me back or am I tripping? She said, I fell asleep in it. She's talking about my wig because she asked to borrow it for one video and it ended up turning into 2 weeks. I said, all right, Diamond, it's whatever. I don't care about letting you borrow things, but I feel like I'm being taken advantage of. And then I said, this is me just being real with you. I don't like pressing you for stuff like that or the bills. We should be smooth. You a bomb-ass female, so I thought. And I don't want to lose you as a quote-unquote friend, but you was never my friend. And we really need to work on our roommate relationship. Then she said, Abby, I understand where you're coming from, but nobody is taking advantage of you. I told you was going to wear it for a video, which is I did the second night. I fell asleep in it because I was sick. You was sick, but you was in Zia's whole or B-Lou's whole music video while they was smoking hookah. Okay. Honestly, I feel like you're overdoing it. I literally haven't been out the house for you to be coming at me like that. I felt like you asked to borrow my wig from one day. I wasn't even home. So there was no key on my door. You would have took the wig anyway. Because you took my clothes without asking. So you would have took the wig. So I said yes. Whatever. Okay. Wig was worn for 2 weeks to the point where Kay tried to wear it recently. And yes, let me put this out here. Yeah, we share wigs. Bitch, I got 100 wigs and I'm going to share it with my bitches or so who I thought was my bitches. Okay? Because if I'm not wearing them, they're in the dust collecting drawers. I mean, they're in the because I'm not wearing them. They're in the drawers collecting dust. So if Paula be like, I want to go green. Bitch, go green. Kay, I want to go 11. Okay, bitch, go 11. Period. So with that being said, cool. Right? And so at this point, I feel like I was being taken advantage of. And I texted her. I told her, y'all could screenshot, flip it, reverse it, because I'm not going to keep doing this. But y'all see, I have my receipt. So it came to a point where I'm like, fuck. I'm like, mommy, like, this girl keeps trying me. She's taking my stuff. Mommy, what do I do? Mom was like, my mom and dad are very religious. They was like, Abby, you made a decision to move in with this girl. You have to stick it out. You signing out the lease. That's the thing. The leases was a thing. Because once you sign your name on something, you have to pay your way out. I'm sorry. I don't care if I'm broke or I'm rich or I'm halfway intermediate. I'm not paying $20,000 to get out of a thing. Like, I could put $20,000 through something else. So, I was like, okay, so what do? I tell my friends, oh, you should have beat her ass already. First of all, I'm too grown. I'm too pretty for that. Okay, if a girl put her hands on me, no, just know. That's different. But I'm not about to instigate a fight. So, mom told me, swallow the pill. Okay, and I thought she was a good friend. So I'm like, okay, whatever, cool. Swallow the pill. Y'all, my stuff is being stolen from me. My stuff is being taken from me when I'm not around.
You call me every second.
I called Kay. So this is when Kay was in Orlando, but I'm calling her, venting to her about all my stuff going missing. Now, this is where y'all really gonna see what's up. The reason why this ended up on social media is over a nigga that isn't even mine.
I feel like it's deeper than that too.
But I'm getting there though. I thought you was my friend. This is what made me realize you weren't my friend. Okay, cool. Diamond was talking to somebody at the time who is kind of close to 600 Breezy, right? Cool.
Kind of.
I'm not trying to.
Really fucking close.
No, okay, really close. I'm not gonna go into details. Yeah, I'm not gonna go into detail because I'm not. This is not their problem, but this is why we're having this issue. She was messing with this guy, which where she tried to threaten me with videos. He got videos on her doing stuff. Okay, so but anyway, she was messing with this guy, and what? Okay, this is my favorite receipt. So. She called me last week when her little thing hit the fan, thought I did it. She was like, that's why you ugly and Breezy this, Breezy that. Like blood, basically. She was like, Breezy this, that's why you ugly and this. And I'm like, okay. So, this is her old number, so I don't care if you guys see it. This is not her new number. This was, okay. So, she said, I got a plug for you. I said, LMAO, why? Let me see. It better be good. Because let me tell you what she did. She was talking to the cute friend, and he had another friend around, and she tried to put me on with him. He was shorter than me. Like, come on now. So I said, it better be good, because she tried me last time. Not my real friend. Kate would never do that to me. Anyways, she said, LMAO, it's his friend. I'm not playing with you. I said, I'm about to get a picture. Hold on. Okay. Who is this?
Brissy.
You know what this is, Kate?
That's Pooh.
That's Pooh, right? Okay. So you tried to put me on with him because he was talking to his homeboy. Before I was even in that new relationship, though. Okay. Hold on. Stand by. Sorry, y'all.
Your ear is swinging.
I know it. Sorry, y'all. So, that was that. Okay. This is what she had to say about him. He big in the real world. I said, oh, he all right. Because at the time, he was locked up. And there's not much I could have said because I didn't know him or see him. So I said, he all right. I'm not pressed. She said, did you get the video? I said, okay, see, I. She said, I'm a little bitch. That nigga got money. You tripping. I don't care if somebody is a rapper or has money. I'm going to mess with you because I mess with you. Okay, cool. She said, I said, no, like he cute. Better than the last LMBO, right? Then she said, I said, put me on. PMO mean, LOL. Put me on. He be working with Drake and shit. I said, put me on. No time wasted. She said, I told my, this person is the nigga that she was homie had before. She said, I told him that. I said, what he said? He said, he the one that told me to put you on. And he said, y'all tall AF. I said, OMG, where he at? So you put the message in, sis. So you put the messages and try to make me talk to Rizzo. But because you not my friend, while I was out of town, you met him in person. You saw that he was cute or whatever. And you, like, called me. And you was like, I think I'm gonna go with him. And I'm thinking in my head, like, okay, bitch, you're not my friend, but go ahead, friend. Because I know if I try to put Paula on with somebody, even if they didn't even talk, that's off limits for me. That's real girl code right there. Like, if Kay try to put me on with somebody, I know Kay not finna be like, okay, what's up? Like, no, like, friends don't do that, okay? So that was the third red flag. So the first one was you didn't have your bank shit together, your finances. Then you wore my clothes multiple times. Then you try to put me on with somebody and then talk to him, okay? Not only did you talk to him, you brought him over, you threw it at him, you fucked him multiple times. Mind you, he was fresh out too, so I'm not trying to justify, but he was literally fresh out and this girl was on his dick. If Breezy was next to me, he would tell you, but whatever. So you did that, fucked him in our crib, in my face, multiple times, and homie hot. You homie hopped, okay? You hit real below the belt.
She's selling out on me.
Wait. You homie hopped, right? So now, I get out my relationship, and now, Breezy don't talk to you no more. He DMs me, he's like, yo, you're actually really cool, apart from all that drama with old girl, you're cool. I'm like, thank you, but I feel like this is wrong in my heart. I told Kay, I'm like, Kay, I shouldn't be talking to him because he was talking to my friend. But bitch, really? But in reality, why the fuck am I trying to hold loyalty to this girl when she really don't fuck with me like that? Really? But in reality, why the fuck am I trying to hold loyalty to this girl when she really don't fuck with me like that.